how's my turban doing in the wind? Is any piece of... You know, Liz had mentioned that my mom and pop came here to the United States of America and started their journey in this great country. And I have to share this because it's very inspirational to see the Statue of Liberty from where I'm standing right now. So my mom and pop came here to State College in Pennsylvania, and they started their journey off in a trailer park with $8 to their name. And my pop was making $225 a month as a research assistant over at Penn State. And you know, I watched as a very young boy, my pop start a business, literally had a sleeping bag at work, and build up a business because he enjoyed the glow of freedom, free enterprise in the 60s and 70s, and built up a business that ended up employing at its height about 40 hardworking Americans. Yesterday was my pop's 70th birthday, and he got to celebrate it with now three generations of our family that live here in the United States of America. And my oldest boy, my father's first grandson, his name is Azad. And Azad in Punjabi means liberty. Mm-hmm. And that name wasn't given to him by mistake. It's a way of honoring what it means to be an American and under the glow of freedom to live as you see fit. Now, the first Sikh immigrants came here to the United States of America on the other side of the equivalent of Ellis Island, the other side of this country, Angel Island. And so if you go to Angel Island, you'll see the names of the fourth and fifth generation now Sikh Americans who first came here to the United States of America. And in the Sikh tradition, we end our daily supplication to God with two couplets that I'm going to recite now. The first is Nemanya Neman Netanya Detan Niyotan Diot, which means, Dear God, bless those who honor the meek. Dear God, bless those who give power to the powerless. Dear God, bless those who give shelter to the shelterless. And then we end in the final words of our daily prayer, our daily supplication, Nanak Nam Jardi Kala Tere Bane Sarbatta Pala, which means, Dear God, please bless all of humanity. Now those values represent the values of this great island, that having a place of sanctuary, having a place of welcome, are not only good secular values, as the father said, they're good spiritual values. And so with that, I thank the Faith and Politics Institute for having me today, and God bless you as you enjoy the next few days learning about the immigrant history of this great city. Thank you.